Good afternoon, YouTube. Today we are going to replace the palm rest on a Dell Inspiration N7010. The power button is the problem with it, but the only way to really fix this power button was to replace the palm rest. So we'll go ahead and get to it. First thing we're going to do is remove the screw that holds in our optical drive here. And we will slide it right out and run them up. Yep, got to grab my magnetic mat here so we can place our screws and know where they all go. Next, we are going to remove all these screws here, and let's go ahead and remove our battery too while we're at it. Make sure it looks like that's unlocked. Go. Set it off to the side. I'm going to start along here and remove all these screws along here. There's quite a few in this laptop. This will also show you the steps of removing the or replacing the keyboard, if that's something you would need to do. That's the one that was missing. Laptop has had some other repairs done to it, we noticed. This thing may have, actually when we looked at it, looks like it may have had quite a few done to it. We're also going to go back and remove some screws along the battery compartment and the optical drive compartment here in a minute. So right now we are just going to go ahead and get all these case screws here, the longer ones. Dell probably has more screws to remove than most laptops that I've seen. Using a magnetic board helps you keep track of the spot your screws came out of, and also helps you keep track of your screws so you don't lose them. Three right down here along the optical drive bay. And there should be four up here along the battery compartment bay, but on this laptop one of them is broke off inside it, so we only have three that we need to remove. There are some screws for the keyboard underneath this. thumbnails, a lot of times it'll work to pull these up. Sometimes a little plastic pry tool will work. Yep. Unless you need to remove the hard drive. But we get to a couple screws under the hard drive, if I remember. We have worked on the keyboard on this laptop before. So it's a sec time this little guy's come to us. Two screws under here that actually hold the keyboard down. We didn't actually have to remove the keyboard when we worked on it. We just cleaned the cables and connectors and were able to fix that. But in this case, we do need to remove everything. So now we're going to flip it over and see about removing our palm rest. And with that, we are going to see about getting a little plastic pry tool here down in there. We use plastic scissors to try and not scratch the laptop. Using fingernails, get underneath there a little bit. We just kind of twist slightly to help pop these clips loose. Don't want to do it too much. Them loose. Gonna pry that away, and sometimes you can slide it, sometimes you can't. It gets caught up on those clips sometimes. We went into a place where it's not going. Sometimes it doesn't hurt to look and make sure that all the screws are out, and that is our problem right here. We missed a screw. Drive going again. Yep. Now you pop them loose much easier. And work across the front here, and I just realized it's kind of up high off the camera. And we're just working our way across here, kind of pulling the case and palm rest apart. Sometimes using our tool to kind of twist and get down in there. Corners seem to stick a little bit more than any other place. That may be just this laptop, but it might be this model, so we will just kind of throw that out there. Sticking over here, double check that our screws are out. Yep, they're all out on that side. We missed one on the other side, so might as well make sure we got it on this side. Tell you what the problem is. We've got to take out all the little screws. Right there, you'll take your keyboard out by flipping this up. Getting way ahead of myself here. Let's go ahead and get our little tool out here. You'll also need to remove this little ribbon here, I believe, and this one here. This one here that runs your touchpad and buttons down here. Actually, I think this one here you probably could have left, but I'm going to go ahead and get it out. And you will have a bunch of screws underneath here that I forgot to remove. Trying to hurry and get ahead of myself here. Confused with another laptop we were working on where the keyboard is part of the palm rest. This model, I have seen them grab a hold here and be able to pull up and get it out. And this one's coming up pretty good. Catching a little bit up here. Yep, make sure all of our screws are out again. Underneath. And no, I did not. I missed some more here. That's why you always double check. You got some screws along the battery compartment all along the back of it here. Like I said, this laptop has a lot of screws. To remove. More than the average laptop does to get its case apart. This is kind of a fairly simple repair, but it does take a little bit of time just due to the fact that you have all these screws to remove. Should be able to lift this guy off, I think. Yes! He comes off nice and easy. Set him aside. And I was right that this cable right here we do not need to remove. We're going to reconnect him while we're here. And easier. Let's see. Looks like we are going to actually have to replace the power button board on our new palm rest. So to do that, we have two screws here. Quick and easy. The board is held down with a little bit of adhesive here. You want to be careful as you peel it off. And that, so now we'll set this one back down there. bring this one back over here. And place the board over the two little pins that hold it in place. And then we put the two screws on it. Normally I wouldn't work on this over the laptop like this, but doing it so that you guys can kind of see here. We took the board off the old laptop. Since it was good, all we needed was the broken plastic button. Alright, now that that's done, you can take this one here and kind of slide it right into place, and you can start trying to snap it down into place. Just work your way around the laptop, snapping it down. Kind of hold it in place until we get our screws in it. Alright, now we are going to put this cable and this cable back. And when you do these cables, they have little black lines on them. You want to make sure that they go into that black level, that line, so that when the little black clip comes down across it, it's covering that black line. You shouldn't see that black line. Then you know they're in far enough that they work. And there we go. Now we are going to put all of our screws back into our palm rest here. Much easier to do before we put the keyboard in. Keyboard here. Alright. Slide it into place. Again, make sure you get this into place far enough. Make sure it is not dirty. Otherwise, you're keyboard isn't going to work quite correct. Snap our keyboard down. And we can close this. Flip it back over. And let's see. So that it actually is the same way as our board over here. And screws that are under the hard drive, put them back. And then of course, if you don't want us to reassemble it, we've already done the repair we needed to do, so we always remind people to like the video and to subscribe to us if you don't want to watch us reassemble. Hard drive back in here, and you still hear the case kind of snapping back together as you do this. There we go. I won't be able to actually power this one on for you because our power cable is actually over at another workstation for this laptop. I brought it over here to do the video. Since it was such a simple repair, I went and figured we'd do it without powering it on. And then it'll go back over there to be double checked and cleaned up and ready for the customer. And just in case you're wondering, no, don't try to zoom in on our Windows key. We've already covered it so that you can't steal the key. After we've done that, we can go ahead and put this cover on. Snap it down and then screw these in. And it popped up. You're kind of snapping into place there. Another one. And now we can start to actually put all of these little screws back in. So when it goes back over to the other repair desk, we will add a case screw to that one that's missing. All of our laptops go out in as good or better condition than they come in. You notice we also work on a towel here so as not to add any scratches to the top of this laptop. There, didn't we? Yeah, actually, missed him. Good thing these guys are all the same size. But again, keeping your screws straight, always good habit. I am going to go ahead and put these in the optical drive bay here. And you don't want to over tighten any of these screws and strip them out. I'm going to slide our optical bay back in. So that we can go ahead and put his screw in and hold him in place. That one right there. So working across the top here, replacing all these. Will be done at the other station is This palm rest came with none of the stickers on it, so we will remove all the stickers from the old palm rest and put on here so that the laptop looks the same when it goes back to the customer as when it came to us. Easier to see these little guys. They're kind of hidden if I have it the other way. Catch and pull that case together a little bit more, and go down in there. I don't know why. That's the one that's broken off. Huh. Remember, I'm actually working backwards from the way the screws are laid out up there. I flip my laptop around. A couple snaps going on as all these go down into place. Especially this not being the exact case palm rest and continue on. Some of our screws are having a little bit of trouble grabbing. So it worries me that maybe this palm rest we got has some areas that are stripped out. We did buy a used one from a recycler. Again here. do some double checking there. Flip it over, kind of look along the edges, make sure it's all back together. Our button feels good, you can hear it clicking it. So that is going to be our repair on this one here. And we again want to remind you to subscribe and like this video. And hopefully yours goes a little bit easier than ours did. Thank you. Good morning, YouTube. Today we have an HP 15 laptop that we are going to switch the cooling fan in. This is the case and CPU cooling fan, as it is with most laptops. Alright, so first thing we need to do is remove the case screws. And we have a little magnetic pad over here. Keep track of all of our screws, where they came out of, and where they need to go back to, which is always important. It really doesn't matter what order you remove these in, just so you know where they go when you put them back. And this model is not going to be as important as some of the other models. I think pretty much all these, except for maybe the optical drive screw, are the same size. And I will point out that optical drive screw here in just a second when we get to take it out. Right here, this one here is the screw that should hold your optical drive in. And actually, he looks to be the same size, so we'll slide our optical drive out, get it out of the way. Go ahead and remove our battery here. And when we do that, we'll expose, looks like, two more screws. Like we're okay underneath the optical drive. Some laptops will put some screws under there to remove the case too, but on this one we're okay. So now we should be able to start working our laptop apart here. And we have a little plastic sponger here that we are going to use to try and get underneath here. Sometimes we go with the guitar picks. Whichever seems to work best for you. And you're going to want to be careful because there's going to be a few cables that are going to be connected here. Your touchpad and your keyboard, which the keyboard on this one is not separate. On a lot of them it is separate and you can just remove it. And that saves that cable, but on this one, it is all part of the palm rest. So basically, you're just going along trying to work underneath here and release all these little clips. Probably should have grabbed me a guitar pick, might have been easier. I got something that we probably missed in the back that's holding here. And they like to hide screws underneath these rubber bumpers. And yep, there they are. So we'll remove these two rubber bumpers here. I can feel the tension at the back, so I realize there's something holding it. And we'll go ahead and get these two out. That's a one of the key things. Just kind of go slow as you take these apart. And if you feel any resistance, go ahead and check and see what's causing your resistance. On this one here, we've had it apart to verify that the fan was bad. So that's been almost a week ago. We were waiting for the fan to come in on it, so it was kind of easy to forget about. And actually, we may not even have to worry about cables on this one. Bottom just comes off, and that will expose our fan right here. We've got a screw right here that needs to come out. And one over here on this side. Both screws are the same size. Now it looks like it frees our fan up. And let's see, looks like we're going to have to unplug the display cable here. To get to the fan cable. So we will unplug it and move it out of the way. That will expose our fan cable that is right here. Just plug straight in. So if you want to use your fingernails and pull it out, if you use a pick or something, you want to be careful you don't damage the logic board or motherboard. And we'll remove that fan, and here is our new one. Even before we took it apart to check, we were 90% sure that's what was wrong, since the laptop told us the fan wasn't working. And we'll put the cable right underneath there. Plug it back in. It goes this direction. Tweezers might have even been good on this repair to help get this fan back in. Alright, now that we've got that, we can go ahead and slide this little guy back into his place. Back down to help hold it. And we put these two little screws back in. As you can see, this is one of the more simple fan replacements on a laptop. This one's not very difficult. Some you have a lot more to take apart. Some you actually have to remove the whole motherboard to get to. But this one here is actually pretty simple. If you were doing the RAM, it's right here and it pops up out. Your hard drive's right here if you need to replace it. So we will snap this case back on. You can hear it kind of snap and pop, and that is everything goes back into place. Once it's snapped on, now we can start putting our screws back in. We're going to start with the two that were underneath the rubber feet. A lot of times the rubber feet will stick on their own. You may have to use double-sided tape or a little bit of glue to help them stick again, but most of the time they will re-stick on their own. also have a certain side they have to go to, and you'll notice that by the little curved edge here. We got those done. Now we will just start replacing all of our other screws. And for those of you that don't want to watch the complete reassembly of this, we remind you to like our videos and subscribe. If you have any questions, go ahead and ask, and we will answer them best we can. Kind of covered how we knew the fan on this one wasn't working. When it was brought in to us, the customer told us that it gave them the message that the CPU fan was not working. We took it apart, tested it, and verified that the CPU fan indeed was not running. And now we will put the new one back in. We really probably should have verified that it worked before I put this whole thing back together, but considering it's a brand new fan, the computer seemed to run very well other than the fan. I am pretty sure that this will take care of it, and I say that in a lot of my videos. Every now and then it does come back to bite me because something doesn't work and we find a further problem, but the majority of the time it does, and gets this repair done and gets us on to another repair fairly quickly. Okay. Throw the battery back in. This one slides in. See if we have any charge. It doesn't look like we do, so I can't. Oh, actually, it is powering on. And looks like we are going to go by without the warning message. Yep, it is booting into Windows. We never got the warning message about the CPU fan being out, so. This laptop is repaired and going to be cleaned up and ready to be sent back to its customer or owner. Thank you for watching, and again, please subscribe and like our videos. Thank you.